capable of loading a bucket, that's okay. As long as you sing out. See, when you're happy, you're going to sing. Amen. Some of us are the world's greatest shower singers, aren't we? Amen. You get some hot water coming on our bodies while we take a shower. We'll sing the whole song by ourselves. Help us somebody. But understand this. He says, sing and making melody in your heart. God says, if he's done something for you, I believe I'll do a song. You recall that in Exodus chapter 15, where the Bible speaks about when Israel was crossing the Red Sea. The Bible denotes the fact that when they crossed the Red Sea and they looked back on their journey, there was a bunch of dead Egyptians, the Bible calls them. They tried to cross over. But the Bible says that when the children of Israel got to the other side, they sung a new song. They sung a new song, I said. They gave praise to God. And I don't know about you this morning, but the fact that the Lord woke me up this morning, I believe he deserves a song. The fact that I had breakfast this morning, maybe the Lord deserves a song. The fact that I had a car to get here this morning means that maybe God deserves a song or two. And some of us come in with a scowl on our face and acting like we don't have any blessings. I don't see anybody in here begging for food. Amen.
Amen.
I see everybody in here fully clothed.
Amen.
Physically and in your right mind. Hallelujah. You could have been the person that was run over a couple of days ago. You could have been the person that died on 285.
Amen.
And just for that alone, you ought to give God praise.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'm so tired of praiseless Christians. Oh, Brother Clark, you're just trying to get us excited, and you're just trying to make us hoop and holler. I'm just telling you, you need to give God what's due.
Amen.
Now that's you. You can stay quiet. But I recall our Lord and Savior when he made his triumphal appearance in the city of Jerusalem as he rode on the back of a borrowed donkey. He came through the city, and the people shouted, "Hosanna, Hosanna." There were some religious people. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
I need to be quiet. Don't take all of that. I'll just hush up here. I'll disturb the worship. Amen. Jesus said, if you stay quiet, I'll make these rocks quiet.
Amen.
You won't find quiet praise in the Bible. Now what you do, that's on you, amen. But you won't find quiet praise in the Bible. Anytime the Bible speaks of praise, it's auditory. And usually loud. Son of David, it is son. That's just something to take home with you this morning. That's the main part of my lesson. Right?
Amen.
Fit right in there. Amen. Yes, brothers and sisters, not only that, you should give thanks. And I love this. The Bible says, for all things. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, the truth be told, we have a hard time giving thanks during times of trials and persecution, don't we?
Yes.
Amen. Sometimes we look at our lives and we say, what is there really to give praise about? I'm unemployed. I'm underemployed. My bills are coming due and I don't have enough money. I got more a month than I got money. Is that even like a story sometimes?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. But God says, give thanks in all things. Preacher, I don't understand. If we experience the effect of allowing the Spirit to continually control us, we will discover that his constant filling is an excellent antidote to a grumbling spirit. The word being filled literally means to let it keep on filling. And the question is, brothers and sisters, what are you being filled with? What is it in your life that you have decided, I'm just going to put God aside for a moment, and I'm just going to fill my own life with my own desires and my own will. Brothers and sisters, I want to suggest to you this morning that God says we got to be filled with something. Now, standing here before you,
I have two glasses. One says you, and the other says you. None of us are empty glasses.
Amen.
Amen. Would you agree? None of us are empty glasses. In some respects, some of us are being filled with the Word. In other words, when I try to live my life, I watch worldly movies, speak about worldly things, I talk worldly, my mouth is slick, I grumble all the time, and never give God praise, I'm a church man, leading church man, don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, worried about Monday on Sunday, can't give God thanks. That's a feeling, y'all. That's a feeling. And what that feeling is, you're being filled by the world. But what the Lord says, if you're a child of God, that shouldn't be your feeling. You should be filled by the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So what you should do is when you go through that downsize, give God thanks. When you have to have cancer treatment, give God thanks.
Amen.
When that driver cuts you off on 285,
amen,
give God thanks.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Because you're going to be filled with the Spirit. And so you have a choice this morning of which one do you want to be filled with? Because you're one of these two people. So when trials come and you get upset, what happens is the Bible says you're going to be filled with the Spirit or you're going to be filled with the Word.
Amen.
So the question becomes, if you're going to be filled with the Spirit or if you're going to be filled with the Word, whatever is in you will come out.
Amen.
Did you hear me this morning?
Yes.
Whatever is in you is going to come out. It could be the Word. Amen.
Somebody. Amen.
Or it could be Jesus.
Amen.
That's the question I'm taking.
I'll be struggling.
Brothers and sisters, bless me, Lord. I hope and pray that somebody here is ready to give their life to Jesus.
Amen.
It is my prayer, it is my plea, that if you want to be a child of God, you be filled with the Spirit. You can do that this morning. You don't have to live a life of wondering whether or not I'm going to heaven, whether or not I can get through this trial I'm going through. The Lord says, I'll be with you always, even until the end of the world. If you want to be a child of God, you must do things God's way. One of the things the Lord says is that he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. The Lord never said, he that believeth alone. You'll never find a scripture in the Bible that says, faith alone saves. The only scripture that you'll find that says, faith alone is in the name. As a matter of fact, it literally says, we are not saved by faith alone. The question is, what do I need to do to be added to my faith? What do I do to express my faith to God? It is not the expression that saves, it is the obedience through your expression that connects you to the saving power of the one who has the power. I use the rough analogy that if I had a vacuum cleaner here, and if I were to plug it up into an outlet, and if I were to turn it on, and we pay the power bill, and I go up these aisles of the vacuum cleaner, I can clean up everything, right? Because I have the power. If I take that same vacuum cleaner and I unplug it, and the same vacuum cleaner has the same ability to suck up the dirt and the grime that's in the pews, but it's not connected to the wall socket, I don't have the power.
Amen.
Some of us are living lives that were not plugged up.
Amen.
And you can't live a life with Jesus without being plugged up into the source. Jesus said in the book of John, he says, I am the vine, and you are the branches. But the branches can't survive unless they're connected to the vine. We had a meeting here yesterday, and there was a big limb that fell off. Some of you will see it off the tree out here. It was a huge limb. I was glad nobody was parked under there, walking under there, we fell. But if you want, there's some pecans, amen.
Amen.
Outside there. They're not ripe, but you can break, take them home and hopefully they're ripening for you. But point being is that that limb that broke off, we moved it out of the way, and guess what? It'll never live again. Because it's not attached to the tree. What you need to be is attached to the tree of life.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, he can save you right now. You're not a member of the Lord's church. You must hear the word of God and believe it to be true. Repent of your sins. That means to change your mind. Confess that Jesus is the Son of the living God. Go down into the water grave of baptism that you have right here today. Rise anew and you'll become a new creation in Christ Jesus. You want to do that? You can do that. As soon as you stand up, I want you to start walking down these aisles. If you want to be a new creature, if you want to be filled with the Spirit, do that right now.
It's so sweet to trust in Jesus.